Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I have six weird but simple guitar techniques for beginners out there that sound absolutely awesome. None of it involved that though, that was just some guitar tomfoolery to grab your attention. Now these are usable techniques that are just a bit outside the box, but they're not too complicated or too showy-offy, so I'm not going to show you how to sweep pick or anything. If you want to hear some crazy noises that are less useful, but just as wacky, if not wackier, we already have two amazing videos on this channel, PMTVUK, where I teach you how to play weird but wonderful sounds on electric guitars. I'll link them in the description box down below. It's like how to do crazy, like make a guitar sound like a whale or like a motorcycle and stuff, those videos. These are actually useful techniques that you can share amongst your friends and actually show off, because it's really cool making weird noises on guitars, especially when done musically, because it turns heads in the crowd. And as always, I've just got six to show you. There's many more out there, so if you want to comment down below your favorite one that I haven't mentioned, share the love, because I enjoy learning about this stuff just as much as you guys. And if you like it, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK, because it's a lot of fun over here. Right, let's get started with one of my favorite awesome ones that I only discovered a couple of years ago, really. It's a technique used by Mr. Edward Van Halen on the Van Halen album Balance for a song called Don't Tell Me. And this is what it sounds like. So that's the intro riff to the song. It's an amazing song. It's absolutely fantastic, with Sammy Hagar absolutely belting his voice over the top. When I heard that song, I was like, that riff's awesome. Let's try and learn it. Doesn't sound right. It's not a pinch harmonic either. How the hell is he doing it? I couldn't get it to sound right. It's only three notes. Like, could I hell get it to sound right until I watched a live video of Eddie playing it? It's a technique I've never seen used before, and obviously you can use it to play the song, but also think of your own riffs and stuff using this technique, and this is how you do it. For the sake of this riff, it's in drop D. So the low E string is tuned down to a D. And it's palm muted, okay? But in order to play the riff, you have to use your little finger and rest it on the bridge of the guitar. So not too much on the string so it chokes it out. Like when you palm mute too close, it kind of chokes it out. I find the sweet spot right next to the bridge. So rest your pinky on it, but don't pick. Pick scrape. So use the edge of your pick and pick towards the bridge of your guitar. Like a pick scrape, but only do a little bit. Pick towards the bridge and combine that with your pinky. So it's just a really cool funky technique that I've never seen anyone do before, and of course Eddie Van Halen is the king of making crazy guitar sounds sound incredibly musical. That's my first little technique. Next up, we have a technique which makes the regular power chord sound 10 times more badass. It's an inverted power chord, and a lot of people know this technique already, but if you're a beginner, you might not know about it. And all an inverted power chord is, so take a D power chord here. Played it in a couple of different ways. The regular way is probably first finger on the fifth fret of the A string and on the seventh fret of the D and the G with your ring finger or your little finger or like barring like that. Instead of adding that octave, which is the seventh fret of the G, use your first finger to play the same fret on the lower string. So you're bringing in, well, the fifth fret of the E there, which is an A. It's still a D. Bring in the low string. Just sound the best on the low strings. So I'm going there's. Bringing in that low string. Guys like Tony Iommi and stuff use chords like this all the time. It's an easy way to make, like I said, your regular power chord sound a lot more evil and give it more thump. The next tip is a tip that I learned from listening to Take Me to the Top by Motley Crue from their amazing first album, Too Fast for Love. And it goes a bit like that. So it's doing pinch harmonics, but down the string. Now, if you don't know how to play pinch harmonics and you are a beginner, here's how you play a pinch harmonic. So you grab the pick in your hand, more distortion the better, really, just when you're starting out. However, like Billy Gibbons is the king of pinch harmonics, as is Zach Wilde, and he plays quite clean. So it's all about the technique. So the best way to learn how to do a pinch harmonic is to pick a note, say like the 9th fret of the A string, and then pick really hard. You can hear there is the pinch harmonic note that you're looking for, that. But obviously it's surrounded by lots of other noise because you're just picking really hard. The trick is to pick a bit lighter and rotate the pick slightly in your hand until you can find that sweet spot where the note kind of jumps out. Because what happens with the pinch harmonic is, to activate it, let's say, your thumb gently grazes on the string itself after you've picked it. Can you get close up my thumb there, Alex? Can't. Just to show you how I've got the pick in my hand. Just like a regular, not too far back, not too far forward. Just kind of like a regular. So hit it hard. And search for that harmonic in that while picking hard. Once you find a nice spot, then take away some of the hardness and relax a little bit. I wasn't even picking a note there, I was just picking an open string. And kind of work with that. So like, use your dynamics if you're picking to, and like how hard you're picking to finesse it once you've found that note. So the whole point of this riff though, like the full and fun little technique I'm showing you, is on an actual open string like the A. And the fun thing with pinch harmonics is, let's go back to that 9th fret of the A. They sound different no matter where you pick them around here. Obviously they sound better on the bridge pickup because in this case it's got a lot more balls to it. But where you pick around here, it sounds different. So you can adopt that into riffs like Mick Mars did on Too Fast for Love. When my band, The Reissues, play the song Proud Mary by Tina Turner and it kicks in, I do that and everyone goes, wow, look at that guy. So that's a fun little technique, kind of working with more than what a pinch harmonic is out the box. Kind of have some fun with it. Next up is something that I do all the time here at PMTVUK when I end a little lead run, say for an intro, or I'm demonstrating a guitar, and that is bend up a note to a major third or bend into a chord completely, because it kind of is a fun way to resolve. And by that I mean, so say E, major third is the 11th fret of the A string. But what I like to do is bend on the 10th fret up to that 11th. So if I'm like, it's a tiny little thing, but it makes a world of difference. You know what I mean? You do it a few times, it does get a bit irritating, but you know. Yeah, I like doing that a lot. That's a good one as well, an open A string and the 5th fret of the G string. Kind of bluesy, isn't it? So that's bending to a major third, but I also enjoy bending into chords and I'd use this a lot as well when I finish little lead lines in that. So, regular A chord, open A string, 2nd fret of the G and the D. Use that middle finger, come around and get the G, so the 3rd fret of the low E string. Bend that's what would be the A on the low E string. Tie that together. Just a cool way to end, isn't it? That and the final one that I use all the time is a G. So that's the 3rd fret on the low E. I always mute the A string, but you can use the 2nd fret if you want. Actually, no, for this case, mute it. open D, open G, and the third fret of the B and the E. A G chord. But don't use a middle finger for the third fret. Use your first finger on the second fret of the low E string. That sounds a bit cool, but a bit naff. It's not a G chord. Until you bend it up. Now, I actually stole this from Ace Frehley. Yeah, that's how to do fun bends into major thirds and into chords. With these string bends as well, they work a lot better on a hardtail guitar. So like an ABR tailpiece like a Gibson or this Kramer Power Vanguard or a Telecaster or a Strat with a blocked off trem. Because when you bend a string, like when you do that, it will naturally bring the bridge up on like a Floyd Rose equipped guitar or a Strat where you actually use the tremolo. And it's harder to get the notes to match up. This low E string will naturally lower in pitch because the bar's moving up, so it's kind of hard to get it perfect. You can do it, but it's just not. It's easier on a hardtail guitar. Now the next thing, the next tip, you can't use a Floyd Rose or Floyd Rose guitar with, you can't use locking tuners because it involves behind the nut bends. So when there's a locking thing here, it's pointless because it doesn't do anything. And it's pretty simple. I love this technique for beginners, intermediate players, or pros. It's just a nice little way to get a bit of flavor into your playing. Now there's a few different ways which you can utilize this. I'm obviously being quite rocky right now, but you can do like cool kind of bluegrass bends with it. That kind of thing, all that jazz. The start of Iron Man by Paranoid. Iron Man by Paranoid. Iron Man by Black Sabbath. Tone Iommi does this for the intro. When you first hear it, when you hear it for the first time, people think it's a tremolo or something or an effect. No, he's just going. And the rest. And I've seen this used to replicate. There's a Phil X video where he plays Helter Skelter by the Beatles. And on the record, Helter Skelter, when George Harrison, I think, is playing guitar on that, more so than Lennon. He really hits the low E string. See that low E string kind of going sharp there? On the record, that happens. Live, you don't want to do that, because this guitar's probably out of tune now as well. The harder you hit the guitar, the more it goes out of tune. So to replicate that kind of sharpness, Phil X does this, and it's just a great way. Replicate is kind of hard hitting. So there's a few different ways you can implement this. And I chose the Charlie Power Vanguard signature Kramer for the next one, because he enjoys a hardtail, obviously, but he plays lots of cool 80s stuff. He's an amazing guitar player. There's a full review of this guitar on YouTube. I'll link it in the description box down below. When you do dive bombs and stuff, gives you the illusion of having a Floyd Rose and stuff. So it's a fun way to mess with it that way as well, and not have to worry about any kind of locking tuners. And last but certainly not least, we started with Eddie Van Halen technique. Let's end with an Eddie Van Halen technique as well. And it's not necessarily a playing technique. This is about the guitar itself and how it's set up. Eddie was a genius, an absolute madman, but a genius. And the guitar by nature isn't really tuned correctly, let's say. Sounds great when you tune it, but when Running with the Devil, all those kind of iconic Van Halen songs are played. As soon as you bar these kind of chords, the B doesn't sound quite right. So what Eddie did for these certain songs was flatten the B ever so slightly, listen closely and listen to the guitar go in tune with itself. A tiny bit flat, that's all it is. We'll be right back. However, because of that, when you go back to regular chords, they're out of tune. Tune it back up for regular chords and stuff. Doesn't sound bad when you play these riffs like that. But if you're wondering why it doesn't sound like the record, or if you're writing a riff with that kind of vibey bard style, and it doesn't sound in tune with itself, that's why. It's a really cool technique for beginners out there to latch onto something which not a lot of people know about, really. So flatten that B string. But remember to tune it up when you go back to play a D chord. I can't stress this enough as well, it's just a tiny, tiny amount. So on the Floyd Rose thumb screws I'm using here, it's like a quarter of a turn. And on a headstock tuner, it'll be a tiny little amount to make it in tune. Don't go like flattening it by a whole turn or half a turn or something, because it will just sound like crap. It's a minuscule amount to make it slowly go in tune with itself. The guitars are a weird instrument, but we love them nonetheless. Now, I'm going to do an honourable mention at the end there. So that's six techniques. But I've been playing Van Halen. I always get asked all the time how to play dive bombs, like... It's kind of cool things. So ideally you want a Floyd Rose guitar, so it's locking at the nut and the body, or an Ibanez with an edge or something, or this kind of locking tremolo system, just so it stays in tune with itself, because you're hammering the bar quite a lot. And all you do is tap a harmonic. Do you know what a harmonic is? Simply rest your finger on the actual metal fret. So not there, on the metal itself. Don't press down, just gently rest your finger on it. They're most easily found at the 12th fret. It's an octave of the whole guitar. But it doesn't sound very exciting when you play dive bombs and stuff, so I really enjoy the 5th fret, 7th fret, and the 3rd fret. It works with one string. When you manage to get two, it kind of goes a bit crackers. That's how you kind of do dive bombs. You can't do pinch harmonics on the 3rd and 4th fret of the G string to sound like Eddie Van Halen. To make it sound like a horse, that's in the weird techniques video from earlier. So that's one way of doing dive bombs. The other way is the Dimebag Darrell style way, the legend that is Dimebag Darrell, one of the best, well, probably the best metal guitar player that's ever walked the earth. And that is to... For this one, you need a floating trem, so not like a Van Halen guitar where it only goes down, it needs to go up as well. So, you don't really need a pick for this. Drop the bar. Strings are flapping around. Let's go back to the G string and use the 5th fret on the G string. So drop the bar, then twang the G string to open it up. Then just gently tap the, well, in this case, the 5th fret of the G. What Dime says is he like damns her in distress. He lets her fall, and then she catches her. He catches her just at the last minute, and then takes her up again. So that's what that is. The 2nd fret is one of the best ones. 2nd fret on the G string, but it's really hard to get. That was a lot of fun, and those are some weird and wonderful techniques for you beginners out there to kind of impress your friends. And shredding's really fun, but if you play stuff like this to a crowd, this will probably draw more attention than someone showing off and shredding and stuff, and they're a lot easier to do. They're awesome. Let me know what you think down below in the comments, which one is your favourite one. If you want to expand on anything or add anything, please feel free to comment down below. This has been a lot of fun. If you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK here on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. If you want any more information on any weird and wonderful stuff, guitars included, like that Kramer Vanguard, this Blackstar HG Stage Mark II 100 watt head. Everything's linked in the description box down below. It'll take you to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and now TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.